Beer Goggles reviews from me, Terry Kay. We've got another one from our fantastic Jens Lidsko. Lovely, lovely guy, and he sent some lovely, lovely beers. At his expense, you know, kind of just that's just so lovely, really is. No ulterior motives behind it or anything like that. Just sent some lovely, lovely beers, and how nice is that? We've got one, is Tool. This is, what's it called, a Danish, I believe. Danish, is it a Danish beer? Copenhagen. Wonderful, wonderful Copenhagen. And this is a Goliath, or a Goliath. Kind of crossover of different religious stories and things like that. You got, was it the Visigoths, the Goths, I think it was. And he was the big champion of the, you know, the everyone, all the kings from back in the day, they had a champion. You know, you had Achilles was one of the champions and of different religions and different kind of mythology and things like that. And Goliath, or Goliath, was another one. And he was the Goths. But he was a champion as well, and he was big. Now, a giant back in the day, right up until a couple of hundred, like Victorian time, a giant was seen as anyone over 6 foot. So I'm 6 foot three, I'd be considered a giant. Three, five, four, five. You know, that sort of thing. So yeah. Anyone over 6 foot was a giant. Giants. It's like, whoa. So like David and Goliath and things like that was David and someone 6 foot or plus, you know. So there you go. He might have been 7 foot, you don't know. It could have been anything. Could have been non-existent completely, and it could have been a story, who knows. But there you go. So we've got Dual. That's two beers. Two owls. And owl is Germanic, ul, owl is Germanic, bibir, and beer is Latin, and he's kind of romance, or what they call romance, it's Roman. Now, this is another one of those that the BB Barfly has trouble with, because it's a little tight cap, and I'm going to have to open it backwards. I'll try it one more time forward that way, but nope, it ain't gripping. Yes, it is. Just about, no, is it? Yes, it is. Right. There we go, just about. Hanging on there by its, by the foil, but it's all foil encased. That's what it looks like. I ain't going to take the thing off because I collect them as they are. Just push that bit of foil back. Good lord. Getting tons of, oh, blimey. It tastes sweet, almost lactose, almost like a, pardon me, almost like a kind of milk stout. Big sweet notes, but you're also getting mocha, you're getting big, hefty Arabica bean kind of coffee notes in there. Right, it's port core. Wow, it's coming out as black as Nougat's knocker. That's an old London saying, as black as Nougat's knocker. It was the Newgate prison, and had the big black like knocker on there that you knocked on that, and that was it. You didn't see the light of day for a while. Near the law courts and things like that. As black as Nougat's knocker. But look at the colour. Look at the colour of that. There's the carbonation coming down the edge of the glass as I tip it away from me. quite lively, but you can't see it through the glass. Cor, you can't see nothing through the glass. Jesus. Let's see if I've got my torch around. Hey. This torch has a slight, very slight blue tinge to it. It's mostly white, but there's a slight blue tinge, so you have to take that into account when you're looking through beers. But there, you ain't getting nothing. Nothing, even right up the edge, down the bottom, you ain't getting nothing coming through, even through the head. You got a kind of quite a brown head there. Nothing at all. No, that is the darkest beer I've ever seen. That is like, that's black. That's Descartes black, that is. That's kind of, you stare into the darkness. Sometimes it stares back. That is proper black black. That's black old black. Oh, it's glorious. It smells like a really, really good, something like, what was the it's another one he sent to me. It was another tall one. It was the Sword Milk, and which is black milk, and it's a black kind of lactose stout, you know, milk stout, lactose sugars and things. I don't know if this is the same, but it was also barrel aged in it, you know. But bloody hell, this is big. It's massive. Oh, blimey. We're talking 10.1 ABV, but this is massive. It comes in a 37.5 centilitre. So 375 milliliter glass, bottle. You could sit and smell this forever. Massive imperial stout, really massive. Right, I'm going in. Bloody hell! Fuck off! God, bloody hell! I nearly swore there. I said, for Christ's sake, I was going to say. God, Jesus Christ! That is... Oh, wow! Jesus, that is something. That is something. Big, big Arabica bean, coffee notes. A little bit of Robusta bean as well in there. Big chocolatey notes. A little bit of kind of pipe tobacco as well. A little hint of that in the background. You got hints of leather. Hints of bonfire ash. Cool, wow. When you get... Jesus Christ. When you... God, that is something else. When... Hence, you're a genius. When you get certain beers, really good beers, you get kind of transported through time and space into different points in your life. And I got a moth around here today, and the missus has opened the purse, and you know he's around. I'll get him in a minute. Save him for her, she can put him back in there. Get back to his family. Where was I? Yeah, you get transported through time and space and everything else, and you and this just is, it opens up so many different, especially with someone like me with a dodgy memory. It opens so many different memories and emotions and things like that. That's a extraordinary beer. Oh. It's an absolute attack of the senses, but in a nice way. Oh, wow. Wow. If you're a bit beer shy, if you're kind of I don't like to kind of poo-poo anyone's taste buds, because some people would have never tasted beer in their lives, but will have tasted will be connoisseurs of wine and foods and things like that, and will have learned to taste things and really pick them apart. They will taste something like that and maybe will get it. If you're a McLager drinker, though, you will not get it because you've never actually tasted what you're actually throwing down your neck. Because if you did, you wouldn't throw it down your neck. You know, you'd throw it down the drain. But that is glorious. That I'm going to sit with. And I'm going to bring a few notes out just before I go. I'm getting prunes, I'm getting currants, I'm getting plums, I'm getting Christmas pudding. I'm getting a bit of rum. A little bit of whiskey there somewhere. Kind of a nice single malt whiskey, a big sweet single malt whiskey. A bit of Madeira. Christ, that's beautiful. That is absolutely beautiful. That's in my top three beers ever. And two of my top three beers ever have been from Yinz. That is extraordinary. That is absolutely extraordinary. And two of them, my top three beers ever, have been from Tuol. That is unbelievable. That really is. Yes. Let's give it another go. It's got a lovely, lovely coffee bitterness. Wow. Wow. Whew. I'm getting all like, all kind of almost emotional. I'm kind of, that is fabulous. Wow. 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 Wow, 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 wow. Bits of licorice in there, bits of cloves, cinnamon. So many different extraordinary flavours in there. That is very complex. It's very, very massive. You've got to get one of them. You've got to get one of them. That is absolutely brilliant. Absolutely beautiful. Must. One of those bucket list beers that, you know, you either want a bucket full of it. You don't want a bucket full of it, though. That is quite enough there. That is enough to just experience and remember something glorious. That is fantastic. Goliath, a giant of a beer in a little small bottle. 375, is it? Bottle. Yeah, 375 bottle. Pardon me. You can sit and put this away as well. Put it away for a good few years. But I've got no idea you want to drink it. You won't want to put it away. Get a couple of them. Put one away for a good few years. Drink the other one. See you in the next one. Jens, you're a diamond. You're a bloody great geezer. You are an absolute extraordinary legend. Thank you very much. Dankeschön for that. That is fantastic. See you in the next one. Don't be late. Cheers. Bottoms up. Oh. Woo. Biddly boo.